Now. Now. Oh. Let us look at. Do we have energy or maybe we should go on our break now? I sense. I think so. We should go. I sense a certain. Now, I want to teach you on guidelines for fruitful visitation. Eight. The name of the chapter is 8. You read ahead. You should read ahead. 8 guidelines for fruitful visitation. Every visit must accomplish something. Every what? What should visitation accomplish? There must be something that your visitation is accomplishing when you go. I'm now teaching about what you do when you go on visitation. You can go and visit somebody and just discuss national science and maths quiz. Oh yes. You discuss with the person, when you finish, you just say, Father Lord, thank you for this. So everybody going on visitation must go with a mission. I'm going, by the time I leave this guy's house, this is my vision and my aim. Yeah. If you want to be an expert, I'm talking to you about the skill of visitation. You must learn, what do I want? When I leave this place, you'll be a committed member of the dancing staff. That's my aim. When I leave this visit, she'll come for rehearsal. When I leave this visit, she'll have her quiet time. When I finish the visit, she'll become a prayerful person. When I leave this visit, she'll break up with her boyfriend. This is a breakup visitation. Hello. Yeah. A breakup visitation. A visitation to break up that which was together. So what is your aim? Before you realize you started playing Xbox. I'll score you. Do you have FIFA? I'll score you. Do you have FIFA? Which controller do you have? No. It's the pad. Let's play again. It's the pad. And then the church members are, if you don't have a vision, what am I going to accomplish as I'm going on this visitation? What's the plan? Always have it. You know, I'll advise you, chapter 29 and chapter 30 of Transform. Every time I go, when I used to go on visitation, not that I don't go anymore. When I go on visitation, as you say, I always read 29 and 30 again to refresh myself for the visitation I'm going towards. What should it accomplish? Number two, it should begin with a social segment. Now, when Jesus visited the earth, he came unto his own. He came, John 1:11, he came. He actually came unto his own. How did he come? John 1 describes the visitation of Christ. How did he come? First, he came with a relaxing social segment. Who grew in favor with men, increased in wisdom, was making carpentry utensils, making coffins, doors. He didn't just, you are in the manger. Then you just start saying, the wise men have come to bring gold, frankincense, and myrrh. I say, except you repent, you die in your sins. You can't introduce yourself like that. You have to be relaxed, singing, away in the manger. No grave for a man, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the earth looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus. That's how we start. I sleep on the hay. Are you? When you enter the house, I feel his presence. I feel his power. Is there oil in the house? Do you have oil? Father, every devil, I cast out every devil. Oh, no. It doesn't work. I need oil. I can't operate here without oil. Kneel down, kneel down, kneel down. Kneel down. There's fright talk. The Lord has need of your fright talk now. You need a what? Relaxing social settlement. Now, you must also, number three, pastors must remember that shepherding visits are not social outings, which means that the social is a settlement. It's not the program. It's not the whole program. Because before you realize, see, your relaxed social settlement is, hey, when you went, the person said, oh, please, can you wear your face mask? And my mother, she says that, oh, sure, sure, sure. So it's very important that we are safe. For now, this corona, we don't even know how it to go. The person says, yes, so. Say, so at work, do you guys social distance? Oh, I work from home. You work from home? And a lot of people are working from home. I even wonder whether when we corona lifts or the vaccine is out, whether we'll ever go back to offices, because now people have realized that you can work from home. Yes, even my boss was saying that maybe he will not lease the office again next year. We'll enter the nice social settlement. Talking about corona. Now, before you realize, you discuss coronavirus for 45 minutes and the social settlement will become a social outing, like the whole outing will be social. So now, one of the skills is the ability to slip from the social settlement into number four, it must be every pastoral visit must be a spiritual event with spiritual impact. Yeah, it must be an event in their lives. So how to slip? So you know, even this face mask that we all wear, I even wonder whether it helps. Because everybody wears the face mask, and people are still getting corona. Yes, even my boss, every day spraying alcohol, wearing mask, and in the end, he got a corona, but he almost died. He almost died. I see. Whenever I hear people dying, I just realize how unimportant things are. If we all die now, well, what is even going to happen? As this corona is taking people, I hear, the last I heard, there were ambassadors and ministers and things. They all died. It's like, this disease, money can't save you. See, it's like, even if you have corona now, you're lying on a bed. You even wonder, is your job important? Is your degree important? What is even important? And that's what even makes me want to serve God more. You should all try and do something for God. Now, I even feel bad when I meet people who don't do anything. Do you do anything, church? You should do, because I even wonder, like, what do we have in heaven? What crown? What do we have? You see, a lot of us Christians, we go to church, and we, the Christian leaders, we don't let them work for God or do anything so that when they pass into glory, they will have something. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. We must all work for God. Yeah. We must wear a crown. You know, I remember Peter said, when the chief shepherd appears, we'll wear a crown. When Jesus comes, will I wear a crown? Sometimes I wonder, will you wear a crown? I don't know. Yeah, actually one of the things I came here to talk to you about, I felt that if you can take something to do for God, just for yourself, so that you have something that is of service to you. And I don't want to, not something that will jeopardize your life or your schedule. I know you are busy, but I feel every Christian should make time and get something small that they do for God. What do you think? Yes, I think so. Yes, please, I can. And we go into that. They say, do you have a Bible? I just want you to read something. Then we go. That's when we enter number five. Every pastoral visit must include the ministering of the word. It's a skill. Bridges. Everything has a bridge. Have you come? The Lord sent me here with one message. I heard it. And he said, power belongs to God. The Lord spoke twice. And I heard it. No, the Lord spoke once and twice did I hear. Power belongs to God. Kneel down there. Do you know about the mystery of impartation? Person cannot relate with you. A visit becomes effective. Look at this. When the power of God is released through prayer. Yeah. Your visit is sealed with prayer. You know, me when I pray on visitation, I know that this is my chance. This is my chance. Whatever I bind on earth is bound in heaven. This is my chance. Whatever I don't allow in this home and in this guy's life is not allowed. Whatever I pray for, I know the guy. I've spoken to him for the last 30 minutes. I know what's going on. Whatever I ask for now is releasing power. Sometimes I pray. I want her to break up. A Christian girl cannot date a weed smoker. So I want them to break up. But I can't say it. But I can say it to God. When I'm even quoting the scriptures, you don't understand, but you should be saying amen. You know what I say, may God direct your heart to love him. And may he give you the love of Christ, which counts the things of this world as dung. And may you embrace the cross of Jesus Christ. And may everything and every person and every entity that Satan has brought into your life to be an evil influence and to turn you away from him, may it be cut off in the name of Jesus. And she also said, amen. She doesn't know that. She's sucking Kofi. Sucking. That's my chance. When I stand in prayer in the house, that's my chance. Yes, yes, yes. Anything I say, whatever I find on earth is found here. It's released through prayer. The power of God is released through prayer. Oh, yes. Father, I pray for the spirit of grace and supplication. Teach her to pray, Lord, as you taught your disciples. Appear to her in the night, oh God, and draw her to you, for your word says no one can come except the Father draw. Father, I pray against every evil thought and idea that is in her mind that Satan has planted there. May she love your house. You see, that's why she doesn't come to church. May she love your house. May she be glad when they say unto her, let us go into the house of God. May she be happy to run into your house, oh God. May she favor the dust of Zion, Lord. May she love to be in your presence. For they go from strength to strength, everyone that appears before God in Zion. I pray, oh God, let the highway to Zion be in her heart. Let her heart be the highways of them. Yes, yes, yes. That's when you leave, the power of God. You know, prayer is such a powerful thing. You transform the visitation with your prayer. Because what you ask for, the Bible says, whatever we agree on is done on earth, is done in heaven. So when you and her are saying amen, or you and him are saying amen, he doesn't know that he's agreeing to things. Hey, something very spiritual has happened. He's agreeing to everything you are saying. All your prayers have been agreed to, and things are being locked and changed. I've done it many times. Let us pray. Father, I come against demons of lust, demons of worldliness. I curse them in Jesus' name. Let them be struck down. Sometimes when I even enter the room, I say, no, that's why she's not spiritual. As I look in her room, her hall, I see pictures of Beyonce, magazines. I see even the way her makeup table is. No Bible in view. That's why some of our church members, they are close to us, but they seem worldly. But when you go on the stage, you say, do you have oil? I believe every pastor should go on the stage with a small budget. Do you know budget? Small one in your back pocket. Yeah, budget, olive oil. Olive oil in your back pocket, small bottle. But not in the room. Father, I cast out every spirit of the world. Let no worldly activity ever take place in this room. It is sanctified by the word and prayer. In Jesus' name. It makes a difference. That's your chance. Whenever you are ending the visit, just realize that if nothing works, that's your chance. Whatever you pray and the person says amen, that is it. And if the person doesn't know how to say amen, you have to teach the person. And John, say amen. And John to say amen. He doesn't know that in the realm of the spirit, he has sealed it. When he said amen, he has sealed it. God help us. Finally, a visit must have a powerful, lasting impact. Yes. The impact of the visit of Jesus Christ is here till today. After a relaxing social segment, what did Jesus do? Look, first Jesus started with a relaxing social segment. Then after that, first of all, Jesus visit. Let's go to the visitation of Christ on the earth. Same chapter, 8 guidelines for fruitful visitation. Number one, every visit must accomplish something. Jesus Christ had a vision. It was very clear. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Why? So that whoever believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. What was Jesus going to accomplish on earth? Luke 19:10. The Son of Man came to seek and to save that which was lost. Why did Jesus come on earth? Matthew 1:21. Behold, thou shalt have a son, thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save the people from their sins. John 1:29. And John said, behold, the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. 1 Timothy 1:15. This is a true saying and worthy of all acceptation, that Jesus Christ came into this world to save sinners, of whom I am. That was the purpose of Christ. It's very, very, very clear. He came to accomplish something. That was the point of the visitation. Now he started with a relaxing social segment in the manger, beautifully singing and welcoming. Shepherds came, wise men came. He was just relaxing, crying, asleep on the hay. Then he came at 12 years old. He came to chat in church, chatting with doctors, relaxing, traveling with his parents. Then all through the 30 years, he was growing in favor with men, making doors, houses, roofs. It's one of my favorite sermons, Jesus the Carpenter. It's beautiful. Jesus as a carpenter, just relaxing, as if he's not here for a visit, or there's nothing happening. Just relaxing, chatting, and so on. People knew him. He was a famous carpenter. This is not a carpenter. I mean, in town, if you meet somebody, most people don't know he's a carpenter. But Jesus was known because he was a good carpenter. Yes. That's what I said. Is this not a carpenter? Is that not him? That's not our guy. Yeah, that's him. A great carpenter. Wow. By him were all things made. So Jesus Christ finished the social segment, and then it was not a social outing for Christ. Yes. Wasn't there to just be happy. So one day he fed 5,000 and multiplied the bread. In John 6, the people came for more. He said, no, it's not a party where I'm sharing bread. He said, I'm the bread of life. I'm the bread. Your fathers ate manna and they are dead. I'm the bread of life. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood, I will be in him and he'll be in me. Here's the bread. And he said, labor not for the meat that perished, but labor for the eternal meat. Then they asked, God, what is that labor? They didn't ask what's the meat. They asked what's the labor. That's when they asked in John 6:28, what shall we do that we may work? Like, what's that labor that we should do? And he said, just believe on me. Believing on me is feeding on me. Yeah. That's what he said. He changed the whole thing. And the Bible says, from that day, many disciples stopped walking with him. And they went to him. Because they came for a social outing. It wasn't becoming a social. The assessment was over. Now, every pastoral visit must be a spiritual event with spiritual impact. The spiritual impact on Israel from Jesus. There was revival from Galilee to Jerusalem. Everybody was talking about it. The people were serving God, praying. There were miracles, healing. There was a spiritual impact on the earth. Then, the ministry of the word, he began to teach. And the people said, what a word for with authority. The people said, what wisdom is this? One day the Pharisees sent soldiers to arrest Jesus, and they came and said, we couldn't arrest him. Say, why? Say, never a man speak as he. Yeah. The preaching prevented them from arresting him. A teacher. That's Jesus, the minister of the word. Then the visit became effective when the power of God was released through prayer. There are very important prayers of Jesus Christ written in the Bible. One is in John 17, when he prays his final prayer for the disciples. I don't pray for you to take them out of the world, that you keep them in the world. Keep them from the evil one. That's what he said. Then he prayed that they may be one. Even as I and you are one. That I may be in them and them in me, and I in you and you in me. That's the prayer of Jesus Christ, John 17. That's the last prayer he prayed. Last but one. Then the most important prayer he ever prayed was on the cross. When he looked down the centuries, 2,000 years of human beings, he said, Father, forgive all of them. They don't know what they are doing. Those were the prayers of Jesus. And the power of God was released through prayer. And then a visit must have a powerful, lasting impact. My goodness. The lasting impact of the visit of Jesus Christ is still seen today. Yeah? So today, the blood will never lose its power. The story is not ending. I don't think you guys understand how serious the story is. It has nothing to do with us. A Middle Eastern man came to some villages and he preached. Then he was crucified. He was arrested and crucified. And he was executed. He said that his execution has something to do with us in Mampo. It's a very serious, the lasting impact of Jesus Christ. So today, sins are washed away because of him. That's a visit. That's a real visit. So, I believe God is making us into visitors. And I believe that the Lord is touching our hearts. I don't even know what you want me to say. Just do the visitation, you know. Yeah, I don't know. Do the things. It's wonderful. So I pray that the Lord will make us skilled visitors. scheduled visitors. And I know that your life will never be the same. Your church will never be the same. Your ministry will never be the same. In Jesus' name. Amen. Stand to your feet. Let's pray. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.